Hi, this is Rob Pavey with a video about the WikiTree Sourcer browser extension. This is the first in a series of videos, and this is the introduction and overview of the features. When I first created WikiTree Sourcer, my motivation was that I found it very time-consuming and repetitive creating source citations on WikiTree. So the goal of the extension is to save you a lot of time and manual typing, both when searching for sources and particularly when creating source citations. Now, as you know, WikiTree doesn't have any collections of records of its own. So what we do is we search for records in other places and then create source citations for them on WikiTree. So what the extension does, it will extract information from the WikiTree profile and then build a search for various websites. And then if you find a record on those websites that you want to cite, it will extract all the information from the record and build a source citation in just one click, which you can then put onto your WikiTree profile. It also allows you to search from one of these sites to another one for similar records. So as I mentioned, it's a browser extension. In case you're not familiar with those, it's a piece of software that runs inside your web browser. And it'll show up slightly differently in different browsers. You can see above Chrome, Firefox, Safari. Works in just about any modern web browser on PCs, Macs, tablets, and phones. And let's do a quick demo of how it shows up in the browser. So this is Chrome running on Mac. And this is a simple WikiTree profile. So here is the icon I was talking about. This little area here is about extensions. And if you click this icon, it brings up a menu. This is technically the extensions pop-up menu, but we'll just call it the WikiTree Sourcer menu. So you can see there's a bunch of search options here. This menu will look different depending on what site you're on and what country the profile's in. One thing that's always there is this options line, which is important. If I click on that, it'll open all the WikiTree Sourcer options. I'm going to refer to these throughout, but I'm not going to show you all the details. But there are a lot of them, and there's a tab for each feature, and then each tab has subsections for different things. So there's many hundreds of options, so check them out. Let's go back to the slides. So there's main features of WikiTree Sourcer. The first two are really the most important, but I'm going to go through them one by one and try to keep it brief. So back on this profile, Annie Mary Taylor, I'm going to try and add some sources to this. She just has one source at the moment, which is Find a Grave. So let's bring up the menu, WikiTree Sourcer menu, and let's do a simple search on Family Search. This goes to Family Search and it fills out all the information it can for the search, like the name. You can see it's actually put both her maiden name and her married name here. It's got her gender, birthplace, marriage place, death place, and dates. These dates ranges are configurable. In the options, you can make the size of the range different. And you can see it's found a bunch of records. Now, if you wanted to do a more specific search, go back to the WikiTree profile. You can search Family Search, and then there's this arrow here. If you click the arrow, it gives you a submenu. You can search with specific parameters. So if you didn't want to include her married name, you can disable that. If you didn't want to include her spouse, you can select specific types of records you want to search, or you could search a specific collection. And this tries to be smart. It will just show you the collections it knows about in the country for this profile and within the time range for this profile. Also, we know she was married in 1884, so the extension, if you searched in 1881, it would use her maiden name. If you searched in 1891, it would use just her married name. So let's do that. You can see that it's searching specifically just one collection, the 1891 England and Wales census, and it's just used her married name. It's still put in all the information it knows from the WikiTree profile. So let's click on this census. This is the correct record. It's got the correct children. And you can see it shows on Family Search, it shows a sidebar with the record details. You can click on View Record to get more details, but WikiTree Source will work either on this page with the sidebar or in View Record. So if we bring up the WikiTree Sourcer menu, you can see there's some extra options now. We're on a record. We can build an inline citation, or we could build a source citation. You just put it at the bottom of the profile, or you could build a narrative with an inline citation, which is what I'm going to do. So we click that. You can see it says Save to Clipboard. We go back. Let's go into Edit on this profile, and we're going to put the narrative and inline citation here. I just use Control V or Command V to paste it in. So you can see there's a narrative here, this part. This is what will show up in the biography. It's very configurable. You can change many things about narrative. Like currently I've got it set to show the exact date of the census. You could just say in the 1891 census or in 1891. You can control whether the date shows up here, what it says here, whether it mentions occupations, all those things. And then this part is the inline citation. You can configure a lot of things about that too. I like to have some kind of white space here with new lines between lines, just so it's easier to read in edit mode. And then if I hit preview here, I also like to have a bit of white space here, so I put break tags in, but those are all options. You can change many things about this, like where this part, the order of things, you can put this part at the end. This part here you could change to be a list instead of a sentence or a table even. You can see there's some links here, so it's created a link to the Family Search record. It actually uses a WikiTree template for that. And it's created a link to the Find My Past image, which you can only see if you have a Find My Past subscription. So that's the start of a little biography. But as I say, this image can only be seen by people who subscribe to Find My Past. So it'd be nice if we could find a record with a free image. So if we go back to the 1891 census, I mentioned you can search from one site to another site. And if you do that, there's also an option sometimes to search for the same record in the same collection. So you can see if I scroll down here that there's information like the page number, the piece, folio. It can use that information to search Ancestry for the exact same record. And you can see it finds just that one matching record with the folio and the piece number. Let's click on that. You can see she's here, there's an image there. So let's try creating a citation from Ancestry. We've already got a narrative, so let's just create an inline citation. Go back to the edit section, and we'll just paste that in after the existing citation. And now if we preview, you can see we've got two citations for the 1891 census. This is Ancestry one. You can see it's created something called an Ancestry sharing link. Now that's a link that anybody can view. You don't have to have a subscription. So if I click on that, it'll bring up this page here. You can zoom in, read the image. So the nice thing here is we now have two citations. One has a free to view transcription, but a pay to view image. And this one has a free-to-view image and a pay-to-view subscription, so it's nicely rounded. Now, we have the start of a little biography here for Annie Mary. It would be nice for this citation, for example, to add a bit more about who else was in the household. So if we go back to that record, we can up here to the WikiTree Sourcer menu, and there's an option Build Household Table. We can paste that in to the biography. can see it uses the WikiTree table syntax. If I preview that now, you can see, as well as the narrative, we now have a little table saying who was in the household on that day. There are a couple of servants. You can see this is the part in bold is for Annie Mary, who's the person this profile's about. So all this information is just automatically extracted from the family search record. So let's go back to the slides. We've covered search, citations, narratives, and household tables. So one next thing is profile transfer. So this is if you have a person profile already on Ancestry or Family Search, it'll help you add a new person in WikiTree. So for this person, let's go ahead and save what we've already done for Annie Mary. We'll say adding sources. So you see we already have two children for Annie, but let's try adding another one. And here we have to type in all this information about their name, and so on to create this profile. But if we go back to the 1891 census we were looking at for Annie Mary, you can see I have that record already on a profile in my tree. So this is Annie Mary's profile. We've already got these two sons here. Looks like I have a reasonable amount of information about this child, Arnold. So I'll go to his profile. We've got the birth and death, reasonable amount of sources. So what I'm going to do, what I could do is just like cut and paste each one of these things individually and paste them into the fields in the add profile page. But you can avoid all that manual stuff by just saving the person data for this person and then going back to this profile, add profile page, and say set the fields from the person data. You can also do that from citation data if you don't have a person, if you just have a record. So you can see it's filled in the names, birth and death. It recognized it said about 1894, so it's put estimated. And filled in all these things. You have to make sure you check this correctly. It defaults, but if there are multiple spouses, you want to make sure that everyone's checked, because one of the options is to insert this intro text automatically with these links, and they rely on you having the correct spouse selected. So in this case, there were no matches, so we don't have to check for duplicates. Now we do need to add a source before we go ahead and create this person. So if we go back to WikiTree, we can just select one of these, like the Wargrave one, view it. You could go view record, but you don't have to. You can actually create a narrative and citation directly from this dialog here. So if we go back, we can put that in. So that's Wargrave information, which includes his death information. Normally I would just create one source here because there's no preview and it's not easy to edit in this box, but I wanted to show one other feature. If you were, particularly if you weren't coming from a profile on Ancestry, if you just manually typed all this information in and you wanted a source, you can use the WikiTree Sourcer menu from this page and it will extract all the information in those fields. So we could search for like a birth record on the UK General Register Office. It will fill in all these fields. Just do search and it found this record. So we would like to cite that. So I'll build a narrative with citation from that for the birth. This is the best site for UK birth registrations because it includes the maiden name consistently, Bardsley. So let's go back. We'll put that in before the record about the death. This is the birth. And then we'll just go ahead and add the chart. So we've created this profile. You can see we've got a start of a biography here, the intro that was automatically generated, these narratives, and these sources. The last thing I wanted to mention is the context menu. And this is something that I added just to make things more convenient for myself. It basically helps you open links. So here's a WikiTree profile, and there's an Ancestry source here with a link to Ancestry UK. Obviously, the person who created this has a UK subscription, but I have a subscription on Ancestry.com. I'm not logged into Ancestry UK, so if I click on it, it just takes me to a sign-up page, which isn't very helpful. Now, I could log in to Ancestry UK with my same account, but that's a bit of a pain being logged into all these different versions of Ancestry. So instead, I can just right-click on the record and say Sourcer, open link in new tab, and it just opens it on Ancestry.com for me. Now, the context menu will work on any website. It doesn't have to be one that WikiTree supports. So this is Discord, for example. And there's a post here that mentions a template. Now, I could open some random WikiTree profile and paste this in and preview it as a way of opening it. But it's easier to just use Sourcer to say open it, and it'll interpret the template and open the right page. Or, for example, on G2G, you might see a WikiTree ID and you want to open that. You can just right-click on it, open, and it opens the page. So that's it, folks. If you want more information, I'm going to create a bunch of videos on different parts of WikiTree Sourcer where I'll go into more detail and show you all the different options. There's a free space page which has details if you want to just read about things. And if you'd like to support further development of my extensions, like supporting new sites, you can buy me a coffee, which is a fundraising site or crowdfunding. You can get to both of these places within the extension. At the bottom of the menu, there's a support donate button, which takes you to a submenu where you can do either of these things. And I'll put some links in the comments or description below this video as well. So watch out for my further videos.